I'd like to open our meeting, our regular meeting for March 21, 2023 at 10 o'clock a.m. at the Rockingham County Governmental Center, 371 North Carolina 65, Reidsville, North Carolina. I'd like to welcome those of you who chose to come and visit with us in person this morning, and to welcome our board members as well, and welcome Tom Schoolfield, who is with us remotely. Will you stand, please, while Jean McDuffie, Eden 1 precinct official, leads our Pledge of Allegiance, followed by the invocation by Pastor Dennis Clements from First Baptist Church of Draper, Eden.
Let's stand at attention. We right-hand salute, and we pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And quarter arms.
Let's pray together. Father, how thankful we are that we live in a country where we can have elections, where we can choose our leaders. And thank you for those who serve this morning to oversee that process. What an important job they have in service. And Lord, they're really ministers of yours, and I pray for your blessing upon them. I pray for wisdom as they make decisions. And Lord, I pray that you would bless them for their sacrifice that they make, really for all of us. We especially want to pray for Tom Schofield this morning. I understand he's not doing well. He's sick. And I pray for him that you just bring healing to him. I know he has a doctor's appointment today. So I just pray you take care of him. Now, in this particular meeting, we ask for wisdom. You've told us if we lack, we could ask. And so we do that now. And again, bless these servants of our community for their service to us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Again, we need to thank Jean McDuffie, Eden 1 precinct official, for leading our Pledge of Allegiance, and for Pastor Dennis Clements, First Baptist Church of Draper, Eden, for leading our invocation. Thank you for coming. At this time, I would like to entertain a motion to approve the agenda.
Madam Chair, I make a motion to approve the agenda.
Second.
I have a motion and a second to approve the agenda. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? You have adopted the agenda, or approved the agenda. All right, as we move on, I need a motion to approve the February 21st, 2023 regular meeting minutes, February 21st, 2023 budget meeting minutes, and March 7th, 2023 budget meeting minutes.
Madam Chair, I make a motion to approve the minutes as presented for February 21st, 2023, the budget meeting on February 21st, 2023, and the meeting notes for March 7th, 2023.
Second.
All right, we have a motion and a second to approve the minutes for the dates that were read. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
All opposed say nay. You have approved the minutes. We do not have anyone who signed up for public comments, so we're moving on to number 7, and which we have voter education and information, which is going to be presented by Member Hampton and Secretary Schoolfield. Secretary Schoolfield is remotely with us this morning, so
Madam Chair, Secretary Schoolfield and I have met, with the elections director. We've also talked with Roy Sawyers and Mike Moore, about engaging the community in some voter education and information activities. Thus far, we've identified probably a half dozen or so activities that we think we should be able to record and upload to various social media accounts. We're working on a calendar, to be specific, about the events that we plan. And once we understand what we're doing is incorporating the calendar that Tom and I are working with Paula's calendar of events, and she's going to talk a little bit more about her events in the next section. But essentially, we're at the point now of developing a calendar of events and trying to figure out just what this will cost us. We think that we are able to do everything that we've discussed within the $3,000 limit that we have between now and June. Tom?
Secretary Schoolfield, do you have anything to add?
No, not at this point. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Board members, do you have any questions for the two of them?
No, ma'am.
Okay. All right, thank you for your information to us, and we look forward to finding out more about the half dozen activities that can be recorded and uploaded and given to the public so that they will have more voter education and information, because every vote counts. We're moving on to number 8, where the director will give us our updates or updates from her.
All right, the first one is the fiscal year 2023-2024 budget. The Board of Elections approved the fiscal year 2023-2024 budget on March the 7th of 2023, and the budget was submitted to the county management on the same day. At your seats, a copy has been provided for the board. From now through April, the management team will review the department request and begin making recommendations. April the 10th through April 14th, departments may be asked to meet with the county manager and the budget finance staff if needed. In late April, the county manager will begin writing his budget message, and on April the 28th, the departments will receive their revised budgets for review. On May 12th, the county manager will recommend a budget and a budget message to the Board of Commissioners. The manager will go over the recommended budget at the regular board meeting on May the 15th. The week of May 22nd through the 26th, workshops will be held to review and or to amend the recommended budget. And then on June the 5th, the Board of Commissioners will hold a public hearing on the budget at its regular Board of Commissioners meeting. And the budget deadline to be submitted to the state is June the 30th. And that is the last day that the county will have to actually adopt the budget. Usually they do that prior to June 30th, but all of these dates, you have them in your board packet. It's this page here. It's just a single page. But are there any questions on the budget? Okay. Moving on to the municipal elections and contracts. Candidate filing for the municipal elections will begin on Friday, July the 7th at 12 o'clock p.m. which is noon, and end on Friday, July the 21st at 12 o'clock p.m. noon. The following offices will be on the ballot for the municipal election. For the City of Eden, there will be council seats for Ward 1, Ward 2, Ward 6, and Ward 7. The Town of Madison, there will be 3 alderman seats and the mayor's seat. The Town of Mayodan, 3 council seats and the mayor's seat. The City of Reidsville, there will be 2 council seats for District A and 2 council seats for District B. The Town of Stoneville, there will be 3 council seats and the mayor's seat. The Town of Wentworth, there will be 3 council seats. And last week, I actually put a map on the Board of Elections website that any of the citizens can go to. It's on the homepage of the Board of Elections page, and you can actually click on the Rockingham County aerial map on the state, and it will show all of these seats listed right below that. It's something that the state board provided to us. They've been working on it for about a month, but it's on there for the public to be able to view on our Board of Elections website. Friday, October the 6th, absentee ballots must be available to start being mailed out. Friday, October the 13th, is the voter registration deadline for the municipal election. Thursday, October the 19th, one-stop early voting begins at 8 a.m., and it will end on Saturday, November the 4th at 3 o'clock p.m. Tuesday, October the 31st, will be the last day to request an absentee ballot. And then on Tuesday, November the 7th, will be Election Day. Polls will open at 6:30 a.m. and close at 7:30 p.m. County Canvass will be held on Friday, November the 17th, and State Canvass on Tuesday, November the 28th. And all of these dates have been put on the calendar for the Board of Elections webpage. So they're available online, and we will be posting these on Facebook as well as the webpage as it gets closer. But are there any questions on those dates? And in your packets, I also provided a list of those dates so you would have them. Okay. And I will let you know, as far as the municipal contracts, we have received all 6 of the municipal contracts back. So everything is good on that. All right, the next item is events and speaking engagements. We've been very busy trying to line up some events. The first one we had was on Wednesday, March the 8th. Kathy and Wendy, which are our Senior Deputy Director and Deputy Director, attended the NC Works Partnership and Collaboration Meeting at the NC Works Building. Everyone at the meeting introduced themselves, and Kathy and Wendy asked for assistance in finding precinct officials for the elections, as well as ways to get information out to the public about the upcoming elections. NC Works will hold these meetings every other month, and the Board of Elections will be able to share handouts, bookmarks, literature, anything that we need to have given out to the public, we'll be able to share that information. And we wanted to publicly thank Cheryl Stevens, which is the Career Center Manager, for the invitation. And Kathy and Wendy both said it was a very informative meeting. They learned a lot of things while they were at the meeting, and it was a lot of partnerships that the Board of Elections will be able to use in the future. The next event we have will be on April the 15th, which is a Saturday, from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. The Board of Elections will have a tent set up at Johnson Sporting Goods in Ruffin for their spring small town craft market. There will be crafts, food trucks, and vendors set up, and our precinct officials, Clara Chapel and Deborah Moore, will be there representing the Board of Elections. And during all these events, we hope to do some live posting on our Facebook page, so be looking for that. And then also the same day, Saturday, April the 15th, from 12 p.m. to 5 p.m., there will be a tent set up at the Boulevard Food Truck Rodeo in Eden. And this is a fundraiser to raise money for a student at Moorhead High School that has cancer. But our precinct officials that will be there that day will be Gail Turner and Pam Kendrick. And then on Saturday, April the 22nd, from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m., we will have a tent set up at the Spring into Madison Festival. There will be music, food, vendors, artisans set up during that time, and precinct officials Glenda Davis and Glenda Pritchard will be there representing our office. And then on Saturday, May the 13th, from 1 p.m. to 9 p.m., we will have a tent set up at the Creative Vision Hair and Beauty Expo at the Chameleon Event Center located at 201 East Meadow Road in Eden. And they will have exhibits and educational booths and vendors, food, music, food trucks, and a bike show. And we're still in the process of lining up precinct officials for that day. And then the last one I'm going to give today, we have several others, but on Monday, May the 22nd, I will be speaking at the Reidsville Rotary Club meeting at Monterey's. I was asked to come and speak. That'll be at 12 o'clock. And that is one of the events we do plan on recording for later on. It may be some of our staff actually recording that one, but so that we'll have all the information that's being said, you'll be able to hear that. And like I said, there are more events that we've got scheduled, but we'll try to give you these dates during every meeting, and we'll try to post these online as well so that the public will know we will be there. During these events, we will have registration applications. We will have precinct official applications, and we'll be giving out flyers on upcoming events such as municipal elections, filing times, registration deadlines. Any information that we give during our meetings, we will also be giving those out during that time as well. So they will have it in their hand and be able to put it on a bulletin board, their refrigerator, wherever they can see these dates that are coming up. But are there any questions on the events or speaking engagements? Okay. Next on the list.
Let me ask, yes. Secretary Schoolfield, are you hearing everything? Okay.
I am. I'm not getting it really, really well. This phone hookup is not very good. But I would ask Paula if she has a listing of the things that she just went over.
Yeah.
That we might see.
I will email that to you after the meeting.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you.
I will email it to you after the meeting.
Okay, great.
Okay. All right. The next thing is the precinct official spotlights. The Board of Election has started spotlighting our heroes, which are our precinct officials that make our elections possible. Please check out our Facebook page, which is the Board of Elections, Rockingham County. So far, we have spotlighted Marilyn Watkins from the Moss Street Precinct at Zion Baptist Church, Roger Shelton from the Southeast Precinct at Williamsburg Elementary, and Patty Bumpus, which is a brand new precinct official, and she will be for the New Bethel precinct at Sharon Baptist Church. We'll be conducting more spotlights, so keep an eye out. Look for that Facebook page, and we will be posting, again, like I said, any events that we have, we'll be posting that on Facebook as well. And both of the gentlemen that were here today, Pastor Dennis Clements and Jean McDuffie, are precinct officials, and you are my hero. So I appreciate everything. And we, and the church, Draper, the First Baptist Church of Draper, is actually one of our precincts. So we have the pastor here, who is a precinct official representing a precinct location. So I want to thank y'all very much, because without you, our elections would not be possible. So thank you. Is there anything else? Okay.
Thank you for coming today and thrusting yourself forward to help us get out that education and information about voting, because once again, every vote counts.
Okay, so moving on, the Board of Elections awning, we're getting a facelift at the front door. The PO was issued either Thursday or Friday, and it has been given to engineering.
Yes.
Madam Chair.
Yes. You may speak.
Madam Chair.
Yes.
Whatever we did to the volume didn't help. In fact, it's worse. I'm not being able to hear any of you now.
Okay, we moved you closer to her. And I don't know what happened there that you weren't able to hear it, but we'll move it back over here where it was in the first place, and let's hope.
Flip the phone over and see if that'll help any.
Yeah.
We'll see if it makes a difference.
Okay. Flat down.
Probably this end right here.
Is that any better?
Well, we're not.
I can hear you, Nelson.
Okay, well, if they got me, they got everybody else.
All right, well, we're hoping to have the awning installed within the next couple of weeks. The PO has been submitted. It has been given to the individuals that are having it installed. So we're having an awning installed at the front door. So anyone that comes up to our front door, they have to buzz to get in. If it's raining, they won't have to have their umbrella there and trying to let it down, getting in, they will have an awning. So I'm looking forward to having that. But is there any questions on the awning? I would also like to thank the county manager for making that possible, as well as the Board of Commissioners for making that possible, that we can actually have the awning installed.
Is that better, Tom?
We are out of sync with the video, and it's probably messing me up. I'm trying to read Paula's lips, and that doesn't work. I'll just listen to the video, not to the audio.
Okay. Well, while we're doing this, I did want to give y'all, well, I'll do that later. Never mind. Let me keep going. All right, orientation manual for candidates. The Board of Elections has been working on a manual to give to the candidates and the political parties that will explain all the different aspects of elections, from dates to remember, campaign finance, campaign signs, absentee voting, election day voting, election night, canvas. It goes through it in detail. It's 45 pages long. We will start handing these out. It's mainly next year's election, but pieces of it will be given out during this election to the candidates. And an email was sent out to the political party chairs yesterday to inviting them to come to the Board of Elections next month for a meeting to meet with me to go over this manual, and at your seats, this is the manual that is being presented. So if anyone asks you any questions, you've also got it at your hands. But the only thing that will be changed in this manual will be dates, and that will be updated with each election. So is there any questions on that? Okay. So moving on to the election training manual. We've been doing the same thing with our main manual. We're going to have a main manual that is about 250 pages. Sorry, guys. It's to help you sleep at night. But it goes over in detail anything possible that can ever come up in any kind of election, and we will be giving them supplemental pages for municipal elections and primaries. But we have pictures. It is larger print, and it will be in a bound notebook instead of just stapled together. So it will be easier to keep up with and easier to read. And like I said, it's, we have pictures. A lot of people learn by pictures, but we've been working on this for quite a while, and I'm excited about it. And first staff was a little hesitant, and then when they got to reading it, they said, wow, I didn't know this. And I didn't know this. Wow, it says it here. So it says anything that could possibly come up, this election manual has an answer. If it does not, we will get it added. So hopefully this is going to help our precinct officials. It's going to help our staff. It's going to, I mean, it's, I see it as a very positive thing. So I'm excited. And but we've been working on this for over 3 months. But it's, like I said, it's about 250 pages. So, but it's a good one. The next item is the NCADE Spring Conference. The staff of the Board of Elections will be attending the NCADE Spring Conference in New Bern, starting Sunday, March the 26th through Tuesday, March the 28th. We will have two precinct officials in the office to cover for staff, and I will be checking with them periodically through those two work days, making sure everything's going well.
Can you give the date again for us, please?
March, it's Monday, it's actually next Monday and Tuesday, March the 26th through the 28th is when we'll be gone. Sunday, March the 26th through Tuesday, March the 28th.
Thank you.
Are there any questions?
Can you tell us what the acronym is for NCADE?
It's the North Carolina Association of Directors of Elections.
Can I back you up one?
Yes.
On the training manual, do you have training scheduled for the precinct judges or others who might use this manual?
Not yet. And that's what I'm going to talk about next. But okay. We will have training on that as we get closer. But the last item is not on your list, the new ADA voting machines. I received a telephone call from Printelect last week that the voting machines were being shipped out. And I received a call yesterday, they're being delivered today. So we will be scheduling training on the new voting machines. As soon as Printelect gets me a schedule, we'll be having that training first. And then once I get the manuals, I'm going to have these printed. And once those are back, then we'll have training on the manuals. I'm waiting on a price now on the manuals. But I'm just excited to have the ADA machines, something that a lot of people, including the board, may not know. Our ADA machines were ordered in 2006, and at our very last election, we had 15 that worked Election Day. So we just did have enough ADA voting, you know, the ADA voting machine, well, they're just printing machines, but they're ADA machines for Election Day. We just did have enough for Election Day. So that was a panic. So huge panic, because we have to have those at every site, whether they're used or not. They have to be available. So I'm excited about the new machines. They weigh a whole lot less, and we'll be able to use these machines to aid in our curbside voting as well. So I'm excited. Things are happening, and it's looking really good. So, and I know that I had been asked for an update on the renovations in the Board of Elections office. That has not started yet, but hopefully it's going to start soon. There's been a lot of work going on throughout the county, and maintenance is being pulled in so many different ways. They're working for in the DSS office. New carpeting is being put down in this building. I mean, they've got probably six or eight projects going on right now. And as they have time, they're working on the office space next to our office. And then while they're doing that, hopefully they'll come to our office and be able to tear those walls out so that we will have the big training area, one-stop voting area at the back of our office. So I'm looking forward to that as well. A lot of good things happening. But I think that is all I have.
Thank you, Paula, for the updates that you have given us, and we will keep those in mind because every vote counts. I just can't say it enough. All right, so we are at a point now at number 9 where we go into closed session to consider the compensation, terms of appointment, and performance of an individual public officer, NCGS 143-318.11 and A in parentheses and 6 in parentheses. Do I have a motion to go into closed session?
No move.
Do I have a second?
Second.
It has been moved and properly second that we go into closed session for what was stated previously. Is there any discussion? Hearing none. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay. We are going into closed session at 10:33. Motion to adjourn.
Chair, I make a motion that we adjourn.
Second.
Third.
It has been a motion and a second that we adjourn. Is there any discussion? Hearing none. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay. You have adjourned at 11:12.